local evening news is brought to you by Nagico, local agents, Bryson's Insurance.
Good evening, I'm Andy Liebert. Welcome to the weekend edition of the evening news here in ABS Antigua's News Authority. A special welcome to viewers joining us via our website, abstvradio.com, and on Facebook Live. Now for this evening's newscast. King De Beer won the judges' approval in the 2019 Wadali Beer Sir Prince Ramsey Calypso Monarch competition. The now six-time winner will be one of two Calypsonians to represent this country in a regional contest next week. Jamie J. Roche reports.
De Beer won his sixth Calypso Monarch crown singing A Ray of Hope and Let the Master Show You. Calypso fans came out in large numbers for the much-anticipated competition. Many eyes were on crossover soca king Tien Winter, who entered the contest for the first time.
You create that nice atmosphere for people to whine, 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 let loose and jam. Yeah, it's all about jamming.
Winter's entry triggered friendly rivalry with veterans, including the Bear, who offered to show him the ropes.
Lest a pen should warn you not to bite up more than you can chew. If you get past Talia, you won't survive the father.
Queen Thede's father, King Zakari, wound up in the second place position, singing Comfort of Thorns and So Much Rasta.
How come all them rust?
Hey, how come so much rust?
How come all them rust? Hold in second place.
Tin Winter placed third with songs Cycles and Let Loose.
Tell Teddy Bear, leave me alone. Nobody never flick no stone at a tree. If it now be a no good fruit.
Meantime, Black Maddie's song Not a Drum Was Heard was adjudged best social commentary. Sammy C received the most improved Calypsonian and best Spirit of Carnival awards. Most humorous went to King Fire for his song Mirror Mirror, and King Zakari and Stumpy shared the best rendered Calypso award. The award for Flo's People's Choice went to Tien Winter. De Beer's win means he'll represent Antigua and Barbuda in the 2019 Leeward Islands Calypso competition in Anguilla next Saturday. This country currently holds that title after back-to-back wins in 2017 and 2018. Queen Thalia will be defending, giving Antigua and Barbuda two opportunities to capture the crown for a third year in a row. I am Jamie J. O'Shea reporting for ABS News.
Well, also chiming in on the high quality of the standards of the Calypsos this year was Prime Minister the Honorable Gaston Browne. He made an appearance on the commentary panel with the host of last night's coverage, Alejandro Robertson, right here on ABS television.
But I think so far that the songs this year, they're good. They are melodious, they have good lyrics, and I'm very happy with the standard of the Calypsos this year.
Now, Prime Minister Brown made no secret of where his support lies, and of course, we all know how that went. His guy, Tien Winter, was beaten into the second runner-up spot. In the meantime, he says, despite the prevailing weather conditions, it is clear that Antigua is enjoying one of its best carnival celebrations.
So far, a very good carnival. I recognize a number of Antiguans and Barbudans have returned home, and let me welcome all of the Antiguans and Barbudans in the diaspora. I believe that it will turn out to be one of the best carnivals, notwithstanding the inclement weather. You can see people would have braved the inclement weather to come out in the numbers this evening.
Meantime, as carnival celebrations continue, the minister with responsibility for national festivals, Daryl Matthew, has given his take on this year's festivities thus far.
This one is already shaping up to be one of the best we've had in a few years.
Quite a while.
And I'm just happy that everyone has come on board, the artists, the producers, the service providers, the Prime Minister who was here before me, and the Cabinet have offered phenomenal support for us having a very good year this year.
He says his ministry plans to hit the ground running after Carnival ends on Tuesday.
Carnival 2019 started in September 2018.
Right, yes.
And so as soon as this carnival is done, God willing, we're on the road again. We're going to start promoting again very, very, very hard.
Okay, the minister is also encouraging persons to continue to make their best efforts to ensure an incident-free carnival. Well, after last night's intriguing showcase of Calypso at Carnival City, there's at least one Calypsonian who is ready to build on the gains. President of the Kwalatli Kaisu Collaborative, Eugene Kasiba Silkut, speaking to our newsroom earlier this week, says this year's season should be placed under review, and he is asking and calling for a postmortem, which he expects his association will lead to look back and review the festivities and all that went on in Calypso this year. And on that note, he says, for too long, the Calypsonians have suffered from disrespect, despite sacrificing to ensure that an important part of the country's culture is kept alive. He cited their treatment during the opening parade as an example where members of the Calypso fraternity went without a float. Now, a major development has happened in reparations for the region. The University of the West Indies has signed a memorandum of understanding with the University of Glasgow to create a reparatory strategy. More in this Jessica Russell report.
According to reports from Nation News, over the next 20 years, the University of Glasgow will be spending £20 million in reparatory justice. The two institutions will focus on how best to use historical knowledge for justice tools and delve into research to push the Caribbean forward. The MOU, regarded as a reparatory justice initiative, states that while the Scottish University would have lent support to free enslaved Africans, it was also funded by people who were made rich by African enslavement. The MOU calls for the establishment of the Glasgow Caribbean Center for Development Research. The center will address the legacies of slavery and colonialism. Another commemorative signing of the MOU is scheduled for the 23rd of August at the University of Glasgow. This will coincide with the United Nations Education, Scientific and Cultural Organization's International Day of Remembrance of the Slave Trade. Jessica Russell, ABS News.
Okay, thank you, Jessica. Just on a programming note, just a reminder that coming up at the bottom of the hour, we will continue our live coverage of the carnival festivities. And this evening, we bring to you the Panorama Competition. 7 bands competing in the Panorama Competition coming up this evening. Live coverage begins at around 7:30 right here on ABS Television. So 7 bands competing in the Panorama Competition this evening. And weather holding fair, they should be off to a prompt start. Well, we've come to the end of the national segment of our newscast. The sporting developments are up next. The West Indies, they lose a low-scoring T20 opener in Florida. This and more after the break. We'll